No one can go back to the past, but through fossils, we can talk to history and perceive ancestral memories. Before they're on display, fossils are usually found on slates or on rocks, and few people recognize what they are. Restorers have to wake up fossils that have been buried for hundreds of millions of years to provide scientific support for the study of the existence and evolution of ancient species. Okay, so how do they do it? Come and let me show you.
Hi, 你好，高帅。
你好，我在修一块贵州龙化石哈。哦，我想试一试。呀，修理化石两种，一个是物理修理，一个是化学修理。化学修理大部分是针对小化石，或者是那种特别脆弱的纤细的化石。机械修理呢，现在主要是目前为止，这个最主要三种形式，一个就是用我们纯手工的，这个用小刀啊。 梯针啊、站子呀、这些的，纯手工的修理。还有一个呢，就是我们用这个气动设备，电动设备来修理啊。另外一种就是我们现在修理那种像海百合类的，普遍非常多，喷砂，它就用这个化石和岩石的这个硬度差进行喷，然后把它修理出来，效果也很好。Now,
which is the most important step of restoring these fossils?
在修化石的时候。 最重要也是最难的，实际上是要把化石原汁原味的，就是最真实的，给它修复出来。你要认清楚哪是为岩，哪是化石，把上面的为岩剔除掉。
Okay, so why do we need to restore these fossils?
实际上最主要的就是让我们认清远古时期这些已经绝灭的这个生命，它们到底长什么样。 给科学家研究了越多的化石信息以后，他们就越来越能够真实的复原我们的生命。So
how long have you been specialized in fossil restoration, and how do you feel about it, personally?
大概有20多年了吧。这确实是个很枯燥的工作，因为每天你就对着这些不停的运笔。但实际上呢，如果你爱它，对它感兴趣，你就觉得是一个非常有生命的一个工作。 因为每天你在跟不同的个体在打交道，尤其远古的生命，可能会给你一个惊喜。It's
so amazing what I witnessed here, and if you want to come and see for yourself, here there is a writing called "Rocks into Fossils." So, if you want to witness it for yourself, be sure to give us a visit and come see those rocks for yourself. It's really amazing what they're doing.